afternoon baseball here on the show. Today we've got a good matchup in store between the Philadelphia Phillies and the St. Louis Cardinals.
And now, your 2000.
It's Cardinals baseball
St.
next
Louis
on the show.
Cardinals.
Daniel Ponce de Leon, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Well, one thing to look out for him, Matt, is if he can avoid the big inning. It's not that big of a deal to give up a run here or there, but sometimes he can be prone to giving up three or four in an inning, and that kind of derails the whole start when that happens. Limit the damage, and he'll be just fine.
And now here is Andrew McCutchen. He will lead this one off today. And a little off to begin the afternoon, as it's to 3-1 now.
He's only four pitches in, but he doesn't look too sharp to start the day off.
The 3-1 pitch. The temperature here at first pitch, a very seasonal 63 degrees this afternoon. High and deep down the left field line.
He got the fastball where he wanted and just pulled off of it.
And another foul ball. Lifted down the line and left. Swing, and he takes this the other way to right. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. Running hard, he's digging for second. And he is into second base as he kicks things off this afternoon with a double.
That's what you want your leadoff hitter to do every time. He wastes a lot of pitches, makes the pitcher work, then to cap it off, he drives one for a double. That might be one of the best at-bats we'll see all game long.
Into the box, Reese Hoskins. Easy there, big fella. 2-2.
Really deceptive changeup right there. It died right before the plate, and he was left reaching for air.
And the knuckle curve that time got him swinging, and that's the first out. So now here is Bryce Harper looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. Here now the 2-2. Fouled away. Runner at second here with one man out. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
We're seeing a good AB here from the three-hole hitter. If he can work a walk or pick up a hit here, he's going to put that cleanup guy in a really good position to do some damage in this first inning.
This one smoked the other way, high and deep to left. O'Neill's back to the track as he takes it for out number two. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning.
Batting fourth, the catcher, JT Realmuto.
Digging in now for Philadelphia, JT Realmuto, runner in scoring position with two gone. One and one. Here it is. Good deception on the slider there as he's way out in front.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball. You could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
The 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss as the slider sets him down for the final out of the inning. Phillies strand one, and now the Cardinals get their first shot at it here. No score. Aaron Nola gets the starting assignment for the Phillies. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
Stepping up is Tommy Edman. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And he pumps the fastball by him here. One and two now.
Well, the key for him on the mound is to keep the ball down. Certainly, hollow of the knee or lower. Sinker changeup guy, if he's going to succeed against this lineup, he's got to keep the ball down.
The 2-2. Little bouncer. Another 2-2 offering. Full count now, 3-2.
What an amazing AB right here, and what a message it sends to your entire lineup. This guy knows out on the mound he's going to have to battle today.
Sent on the ground out to second. Segura has it, and there's one down now.
Batting second, the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt now. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses, nope. Ball two.
Count 2-1.
Three and one.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
All over that one, but a little out in front. Foul ball. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Another payoff pitch. Pulled high in the air out to left field. McCutchen is under it. Two down.
That is good.
Here's Nolan Arenado. His past line against Aaron Nola. He's a 375 hitter. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here's a fly ball, well hit. McCutchen looking up. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. Nolan Arenado touches them all, and the Cardinals move out in front 1-0.
Yeah, we always talk about how important it is to spot your starter a run or two early in the game, and he does just that, blasting a no-doubt bomb that serves notice. They're going to be swinging with the wood here. No better way to get the home crowd into it right out of the gates.
At the plate, Paul DeJong. And he fouls this one off. Two out, nobody on. Bouncer up the middle. There's Segura. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. One for the Cardinals in the inning on the solo home run. We'll head to the top of the second, and the Redbirds have an early 1-0 advantage. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring up Alec Bohm. The 1-1 is taken for ball two. Inside for a ball as he falls behind to him here, 3-1. into the windup and the pitch. And that misses for ball four. So it's a leadoff walk here to start the second.
Yeah, and as a starter, the last thing you want to do is let a team answer when your guys just scored a run for you. So he's thinking ground ball right here to try to get a double play and end this threat.
So next to the plate for the Phils, Didi Gregorius. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. Ready with the 1-2. Back up the middle. And that's through for a hit.
He had him on the ropes right there. Count leverage, two strikes against the batter. He's going to have to put that into memory bank because that guy made a nice two-strike approach right there, made a nice two-strike adjustment.
Stepping in now, Gene Segura. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. Sent on the ground out to second. And that's through into right field for a base hit. He'll come home with it. But this won't be in time as he's well safe and the run scores.
Batting it, the center fielder, Adam Haseley.
To the plate now, Adam Haseley. Too high that time, and it's 3-1.
There isn't a hitter alive that doesn't love hitting at fastball counts like 3-1. It's usually a pretty fruitful count in terms of getting a pitch to drive.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Gregorius at second, Segura at first with no outs. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
We knew coming into this game that this guy has a tendency to give up a lot of free passes, and history repeats itself as he's already given up two walks here. I'll tell you, effectively wild is a pretty tough thing to be.
Next to hit will be the pitcher, Aaron Nola, and a golden opportunity here to give his guys the lead with three men aboard. The 1-1 home is laid off for ball two. Pitch is piling up, 44, and he's not clear of the second yet. In there, 2-2.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Aaron Nola goes down to become the first out here in the second inning. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Andrew McCutchen, 1-for-1 as he reached base with a double his first time up.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
And a strike three called. My gracious, what a pitch with the bases loaded. And there are two away now.
Reese Hoskins.
So the bases are loaded here, two men gone, and that'll bring up Reese Hoskins. Two out, bases loaded. And this ball runs away for ball two, 2-1.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
Two and one, here it is.
Hey, after those two breaking balls missed, you have to be sitting on a fastball right here.
The set and the 3-1 pitch. Fastball in there, 3-2.
Definitely a big pitch coming up right here. He's going to be pumped if he can work his way out of this inning with the game still tied.
Bases are loaded here, two down. But this won't get by the shortstop as he's there to take it in for the third out. Phillies get a couple of hits here, and it leads to one on the scoreboard. Stepping in for the Cardinals, Tyler O'Neill. His pass lined against Aaron Nola. He's 2 for 3. He's taken him deep once. The catcher wanted it down, and they got him to chase it for strike two.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
Full count, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Gets him swinging. He struck him out.
I think he had his mind made up. He was swinging the bat and trying to protect before the ball even left the pitcher's hand. That pitch wasn't even close. He would have needed a flagpole to hit that one.
In now, Yadier Molina. This is foul right side. Bases are empty, one man in. And he loses him on a breaking ball.
Batting seven, the center fielder, Gillen.
The next to bat for St. Louis, Dylan Carlson, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
Well, that's just a quality pitch right there. The location was excellent because if it's put in play, there's a good chance it's on the ground for a double play. And, hey, a strikeout always works too.
So now to the plate, Justin Williams. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1. Grounded to short. Gregorius has it. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. One left for the Cardinals. We played two full innings, and we are tied 1-1. Welcome back to Busch Stadium as we send it down to Heidi.
Matt, I had a chance to catch up with manager Joe Girardi during the commercial break about the Phillies offense. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up. And he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Top of the third set to get underway. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Bryce Harper. The 1-2.
Can we be honest here? That was a terrible pitch. That was right over the heart of the plate. Two strikes on the guy. He is lucky he's getting his pitch back.
And this is swung on and missed. Five quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. I might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead, he gets the fastball way late. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
Into the box now, JT Realmuto. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Well, he's really laboring in the early going here. That's his third walk of the game already. We'll see if he can get it together or if this is just one of those days where he's going to have to grind his way through this start.
That brings up Alec Bohm. He reached on a walk in his last time up and later came around to score. Runner on first here with one gone and a 1-1 tie. Lays off, 2-2 now. Cardinals are going to get something going in the bullpen now as a left-hander has begun to get loose. Hit out towards second. And that finds its way through for a base hit. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
I mean, that has to frustrate the guy on the mound right there. You get him down 0-2, no put away pitch, works the count back to neutral, and is able to mix in a base hit. Nice job.
At the plate, Didi Gregorius, and it's fouled away. Fouled off.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. One pitch, two outs. A pitcher's best friend in the inning. Mark, Dan, and I are back with more after this. Matt Carpenter will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out. Into the box, Tommy Edman. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. One out, nobody on. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And that misses off the plate and low, so it's 3-1 now. On deck, the powerful right-handed bat of Paul Goldschmidt. The 3-1 pitch is in there for a full count now, 3-2.
Not the ideal location for a changeup up in the zone, but he got away with it.
Swung on, but fouled off to the left. The 3-2 one more time. Fouled away. Another one sent foul. The next 3-2. High in the air out to center field. Haseley is right there. And that's out number two. And that brings up Paul Goldschmidt. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB. Two-out lightning definitely applies to this offense. If this two-hole hitter can get on, they could start something serious.
The 3-2 pitch. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
So it's a runner at first with two gone. And in next, it'll be the perennial MVP candidate, third baseman Nolan Arenado.
Yeah, not fooled by that breaking ball in his last AB at all. He jumped all over it. That's such a good feeling as a hitter when you know you're picking up.
We'll have to leave it there as the play is made for the third out. Cards leave one through three complete, all tied one apiece.
Hey,
Genesis Cabrera, a 6'2" left-hander, jogs in to take over on the hill. All set for the start of the fourth, and set to go is the second baseman, Gene Segura. The 2-1 on its way. 2-2.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going. The 2-2. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Man, I love watching a pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitch, and for me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
Stepping in now, Adam Haseley. 1-1 pitch is a curveball that misses ball two. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now. The 2-2 is looked at and the count moves full.
Looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
Good swing just a little early, and he'll see another payoff pitch. He'll try it again, 3-2. Full count still. Once again, a 3-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Right fielder giving chase. He makes the running play. 2 down. Next up will be the Phillies pitcher, Aaron Nola. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
And you can live with punching out with the bases empty, but in his last at-bat with 2 runners in scoring position, you cannot go down not putting the ball in play. Too much on the line, too many ribby opportunities out there to swing and miss in that spot.
Everything this guy throws is hard. That changeup he throws is in the high 80s to go along with that good heater.
1 run, 4 hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Sharp ground ball to third. Arenado has it. Over to first, and that retires the side. 3 up, 3 down for Philadelphia. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth, tied 1-1. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cardinals to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored 1 run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and stepping up as the shortstop, Paul DeJong. Knuckle curve there, and he thought he had him, but it's 2-2.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Down the line and fair, that's a hit. And now it'll kick around in the corner. And he's going to make it. He's in at second base with a leadoff double. Not every day that you see a ball come off the bat like that one did. And looking at it again on show track, we see it a lot faster than it came in. 113 miles an hour. Couldn't have hit that one much better than that. To the plate now, Tyler O'Neill. And it's one and two.
Hey, he's got great feel for that pitch right there. He can throw it anytime he wants for a strike.
On a good changeup, a swing and a miss, and he's set down on strikes for the second time today.
Wow, that's one of the toughest pitches in baseball to hit, right? That good straight changeup, El Cambio. There's not much you can do with that. You're going off of that arm speed and the ball, it just doesn't get there.
At the plate now, Yadier Molina. In the dirt here. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. He's set. Now the pitch.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And Molina swings and misses that time as he's a strikeout victim here. Two away.
Now, after back-to-back strikeouts, he's got a real good chance of making that leadoff double pretty much meaningless. He's made some good pitches, and these hitters have really failed driving him in or at least getting him over.
In now, Dylan Carlson. One and two now.
One ball, two strikes, yeah.
Check swing here, but he holds up far too late as it's strike three and the inning is over. When we return, it'll be Andrew McCutchen to start things out. On to the top of inning number five we go, all tied at 1-1. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Andrew McCutchen. Look into Molina, now the 1-1. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
Leading off the inning, your job is to get on base and set the table for the inning. That was a pretty good at bat, and that he pushed the count to 3-2 and made the pitcher work. But I think he'd like to have that 3-2 pitch back. Pretty sure that was ball four he went after.
Standing in now, Rhys Hoskins. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Bases are empty, one man out. Snatched out of midair at first base for out number two.
The right fielder, number three.
Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. The 3-1 pitch. And he lost him. Ball four as Harper will reach.
Well, he walked him on five pitches, but that last pitch was really good. He missed down, but only by a hair. When a hitter has a 3-1 count, he can wait until he gets a pitch he loves.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, JT Realmuto. It was a walk in his last trip. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. One left for Philadelphia. Halfway home, all even at one apiece. Now at the plate is Justin Williams. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. from the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Here's a swing and a ball hit into the air to left center and shallow. There to take it is Gregorius for the first out.
Boy, he showed some pretty good range heading pretty deep into the outfield to bring that one down. Thought the outfielder might call him off, but he clearly had it under control.
Andrew Kisner will come on as a pinch hitter to try and make an impact with one away. Try to hold back on the pitch inside, but he pretty clearly broke the plane that time. It's strike two. One run, two hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. Liner towards second, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
The batter number 19, second baseman, Tommy.
So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in Tommy Edman. Changeup just off the black, and it's 2-1. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Set and the 2-1 pitch. Kisner, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Always tough for one of these base umpires to make a call on a guy's check swing. It's not a great angle, and everything happens so quickly, so they really have to be paying attention out there. Looking at the replay, I think he got it right, so that's a tip of the cap for the Blue.
Here comes the 1-2. And that's a swinging strike three in the dirt. And that ends the inning. One hit, one left. We're through five here at the ballpark, all tied at 1-1. John Gant takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Now into the box, Alec Bohm. He'll lead things off here in the Philadelphia sixth. Popped up. Goldschmidt has room in foul territory. Makes the play, one away. Next to hit is Didi Gregorius. One for two in the ballgame thus far. The 1-1. And he fouls this one off. One out, nobody on. A two-seamer there as this is fouled off to the left side. He's set and the 1-2 pitch. And this is swung out and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the sixth inning.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Into the box, Gene Segura. Here's a little chopper up the middle. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Phillies down in order. Score remains deadlocked at one. Ready now is Nolan Arenado. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Now the 1-1 pitch is looked at for ball number two.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Now the pitch. Strike two as that's taken on the outside part of the plate. Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Boy, this is a tight one. You kind of get the feeling like the next team that scores is going to win this one.
And the pitch. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Here for it is Segura to make the play. One gone.
Now batting.
And now the Cardinals' number four hitter, Paul DeJong. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Bases are empty, one man out. Two balls and a strike. Hit sharply on the ground and into center field as he's aboard with a one-out single.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
Here comes the Philly skipper on his way out toward the mound. And a change is in the offing as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. He'll depart with our score tied, and he'll still be accountable for the runner at first, and the best he can do is a no decision in this one. Connor Brogdon enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. Stepping in now, Tyler O'Neill. Fastball called strike, 1-2.
Hey, that's a quality take right there. He knows the pitcher's trying to get him to hit a ground ball and roll two.
Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. Just trying to freeze him with the fastball there. Pretty close, it's 2-2. Three and two now.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with the strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
So now to the plate, Yadier Molina. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. As a look, now the pitch. Hit hard on the ground to second. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left. Seventh inning coming up, all tied at 1-1. Seventh inning ready to roll, and Adam Haseley digs in now. The 2-1. Oh, that grounder got him. Throw to first, but he's safe. And now the stadium's attention turns back to the man on the mound. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it. It looked like it got him on his drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. Ronald Torres will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot. go-ahead runs aboard here at first with nobody out. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. In the dirt, and now let's see. And he is in there. They couldn't get him at second. And a very big mistake, as that'll move the possible go-ahead run into scoring position. The 2-2. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with nobody out. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Fastball got him looking, as that had two-seam action on it, one gone. So the Phillies batting order turns over and set to go. Andrew McCutchen, lifetime versus this arm, batting at an even 400. The 1-1 home. Liner towards second. And he has just given them the lead late, as this is down for extra bases. And the runner from second is in to score. It's now a 2-1 ball game. And McCutchen is into third base with a triple.
Dan, you'll take RBIs any way you can get them, but when they give your team the lead in the late innings, man, that feels good.
Oh, it especially does, especially when you start to score runs late in the game off of quality pitching. When runs are at a premium, that's one that makes you feel really good about yourself.
And that'll bring up the Sacramento product, Rhys Hoskins. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
McCutchen takes his lead at third with one away. And it's fouled away.
The offensive approach here is simple. You know the pitcher's going for the K, so set your sights middle of the plate. And then don't worry about the infielders. They're so close, hard contact is a guaranteed ribby.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Rhys Hoskins goes down for out number two in the top half. Harper. Into the box now, Bryce Harper. Can't catch the corner away with the fastball. It's 2-1. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two. Men on third with two down. And he comes back with one down and in for ball three.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Now a ball ripped into deep center field. Carlson able to track it down for the third out.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the traditional.
Phils get just one despite this RBI triple. Get up and stretch. Now 2-1 Philadelphia. Brandon Kinsler gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh. Last half of the seventh here, and coming forward is the switch hitting outfielder, Dylan Carlson.
No, you're only down one right here, but the exploding stuff that's coming out of the back end of a lot of teams' bullpens. I mean, just north of 95 plus. Stuff diving all over the plate. It's gotten a lot tougher to scratch across runs against these teams' bullpens.
And he'll indeed make the play in foul territory for the first out.
Now that.
Next up is Justin Williams. 0 for 2 here to start the afternoon. And there's ball two now. Now some movement out in the Phillies' bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen. All even now, 2-2. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel, 2-1 our score. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
Well, that was a slider in a 3-2 count, and it just didn't tempt him enough to get a good swing. A good job of pitch recognition and knowing the strike zone to draw the free pass there.
Edmundo Sosa will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. From the belt, the pitch. Grounded back up the middle. A diving effort as it's off his glove. But he'll recover to get the force at second. A fantastic play.
Hey, that's great teamwork, I guess. Not a pretty out, but helping your teammate out like that and then knowing he had time to go to second for the out is a pretty heads-up play. I got to think there's some good communication down there between the infielders as that play unfolded.
In now, Tommy Edmund. Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. A runner on first with 2 away. That will conclude matters here in the seventh. One left for the Cardinals. They still trail it here 2-1. Jordan Hicks has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Now it'll be the four-hole hitter, JT Realmuto. No hits to this point. The 1-1 is a slider taken for a ball. Swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. He leaps, but he can't get it. It's down for extra bases. And he will pull into second with a leadoff double.
Up next,
wow, he almost made a heck of a play in left.
Yeah, Batty, you can't fault the left fielder there. You'll see he makes a tremendous effort, but he just can't haul it in, and it gets past him for an extra base hit. Like the effort, though.
At the plate, Alec Bohm. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1. Cardinals get the bullpen started here as a right-hander's up and warming. Heading out towards shallow right. Here comes the right fielder. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning.
Now back.
Here's Didi Gregorius. Philly shortstop in front of the count 3-1. Gene Segura waits on deck. The 3-1.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. The payoff pitch one more time. Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. Might have swung at ball four there as he manages to foul this one away. Another full count pitch home. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Long run for the right fielder. He gets there, and that's the second out. So a runner at second. Two down now, and that'll bring in the middle infielder, Gene Segura. Fouled off. Real Muto stands at second with two gone. And here's a pitch inside, and that got him.
Yeah, it was a great battle there, and he was one strike away from putting him away. As a pitcher, you hate to put a guy on for free after all that work.
To the plate now, Adam Haseley. And not a real good cut at that slider, and he's behind 1-2.
Boy, the Phillies have been looking for some offense all game long. They've yet to find it. Let's hope they can find it pretty soon.
In the dirt, goes to third with it, and oh, they say he beat the throw, safe at third. So now two men in scoring position. Second and third, two away. Fastball is outside, and it's full now, 3-2.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
Ready with the payoff pitch. Down on strikes, so they get two men into scoring position, but that's as far as they'll get as the side is retired. Phillies leave a couple. They still lead it 2-1. And Joe Girardi's going to get up off the dugout bench and confer at home plate, so we'll likely see a double switch here. Archie Bradley will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Brad Miller will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hole in the order here on that double switch. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And stepping in, the power hitting first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt. Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike two. And now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Hit sharply but foul down the right side. Here's another 1-2. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Well, no preferential treatment there. Sometimes we see great hitters have their calls go their way on close pitches, but not this time. I think that was actually a good take, but on two strikes, anything that close can go either way.
At the plate now, Nolan Arenado. 3-2, full count.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
Slapped hard the opposite way, and that's in for his second hit of the afternoon.
You never want to beat a pitcher that breaks a guy out of a slump. But this guy was too good. You knew it was a matter of time before he started barreling baseballs. That gives him a multi-hit game, and I'm sure he's feeling good about it.
Stepping in now, Paul DeJong. 2-1 pitch, a knuckle curve swung on and missed, 2-2.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
From the stretch. And strike three called on the outside corner. He's earned a right to live out there with the fastballs as that's out number two.
That's a big strikeout there with the tying run over at first base. Now, with two outs, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that guy home. Probably need a ball in the gap to give him a chance.
Into the box now, Tyler O'Neill. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Harper has a read on it, and he makes the catch to retire the side. Cards leave one. They're down 2-1. Ryan Helsley enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Brad Miller. Here comes the 1-2. A shot down the first baseline, and a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball.
Hey, this looks like it could be a potential add-on inning here in the ninth. Add-on gives some breathing room to their pitcher going into the bottom of the inning, D-Row.
Yeah, you love when the offense stays aggressive. And you also like giving your relief pitcher a chance to breathe a little bit, not having to come out there with just a one-run lead.
Standing in now, Andrew McCutchen. Wisely lays off the cut fastball there. It's 2-1. Miller gets his lead at first, nobody out. Needed a sand wedge for that one. Swung on and missed.
That's exactly the pitch you don't want to be chasing in these situations. He's going to keep that ball down below the hollow of the knee, try and get you to ground into a double play. You have to set your sights at least belt high.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
That's the third time in this game he's gone down on strikes. Not the game he was hoping to have when he was taking batting practice, but at least his guys are ahead.
In now, Reese Hoskins, lifted down the line in left.
When the guy on the mound has complete command of his off speed, especially his changeup, sometimes as a hitter, you just have to give up pull side to stay on it.
Fouled away. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. And he fouls this one off. Here's the 2-2.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put away stuff.
The 2-2 one more time. And he'll get to see another one. It'll be the 10th pitch of this at bat. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one.
He's definitely going to want to get greedy in his zone, and he's obviously seeing the ball well, or he would have swung at that pitch. Sometimes in these long, epic at bats, you start to get into swing mode.
3-2 pitch. Now a changeup just off the plate as that misses for ball four.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
At the plate, Bryce Harper, 1-2.
He got a swing and a miss on that last pitch, but that's not the location he wants to live in against a hitter of this quality.
And it's fouled away. Again, a 1-2. Sent out to straightaway center field. Carlson is there now, and he has it, two gone. Big spot here. First and second, two men gone, and that brings up JT Realmuto. One-run game here in the top of the ninth. Fouled off. Strike him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head in for their final set of swings. Phillies leave a couple. They lead it 2-1. Hector Neris takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door. Here's the catcher, Yadier Molina. His career numbers against Hector Neris. He's hitless in 3 at-bats. The 1-1. Hit the other way out toward right field. Harper has a read on it. Makes the play, one away. Next, it'll be Dylan Carlson, popped into foul ground his last time up.
Yeah, this one's going to upset him for a little bit. You make the pitcher work the way he did right there, and that's the end result. That one sticks with you for a while.
And a bouncing ball, foul. Hard sinker misses, 2-2. One out, nobody on. This one's blooped out toward right center field. Miller waits on it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Now to bat, Justin Williams. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. Fans on their feet in a one-run ball game in the last of the ninth. Swing and a miss, and they're up against it now as they're down to their final strike of the afternoon.
You got to be paying attention as an offense in a hitter's meeting in this situation. When you got a guy on the mound that you know the bottom can drop out of any pitch he throws, you have to elevate your sights.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Hey, which is normally the case in these close ones. You have a one-run game, a 2-1 decision. Really good pitching and defense in this one, and a lot of really good execution made this a fun game to watch.
Pitching and defense game, 2-1, the final score this afternoon. Philadelphia jumped ahead in the seventh inning and never gave the lead back. Connor Brogdon takes home the win. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Philadelphia Phillies. 2 runs on 8 hits. No errors. They left 12 men on base.